Rachel Mann with the Penguin Random House Library Marketing Department, and these are my 3 and 3 stack picks. The theme for the books I'm recommending today is women's fiction. Whether in the suspense space, the literary space, or the contemporary, these books are great for anyone looking to read about complex women. The first book I'd like to recommend today is Catch Her When She Falls, a suspense novel by Allison Bicola. When Micah Wilkes was a senior in high school, her boyfriend was convicted of murdering her best friend, Emily, a star ballerina with a bright future. A decade later, Micah has finally moved on from the unforgivable betrayal and loss. But when reminders of her past begin appearing at her work and home, Micah begins to doubt what she knows about Emily's death. Questions raised on a true crime blog and an online web sleuthing forum force her to re-examine her memories of that fateful night. As Micah delves deeper into the case, she feels her grip on reality loosening, her behavior growing more and more secretive and unhinged. As she races to piece together the truth about that night 10 years ago, Micah grapples with how things could have gone so wrong and wonders whether she too might be next to disappear. This taut psychological thriller is great for fans of Ruth Ware and Paula Hawkins. And next, the second novel I'd like to recommend is Joan Is Okay by Wagyi Wang. Joan is a 30-something ICU doctor at a busy New York City hospital, the daughter of Chinese parents who came to the United States to secure the American dream for their children. Joan is intensely devoted to her work, happily solitary and successful. She does look up sometimes and wonder where her true roots lie. At the hospital, where her white coat makes her feel needed, or with her family, who try to shape her life by their own cultural and societal expectations. Deceptively spare and quietly powerful, and laced with sharp humor, Joan Is Okay touches on matters that feel deeply resonant. Being Chinese American right now, working in medicine at a high stakes time, finding one's voice within a dominant culture, being a woman in a male-dominated workplace, and staying independent within a tight-knit family. But above all, it's a portrait of one remarkable woman so surprising that you can't get her out of your head. This is a piercingly insightful new novel from a marvelously complicated woman who can't be anyone but herself from the award-winning author of Chemistry. And finally, the third novel I'd like to recommend is Brown Girls by Daphne Palissy Andrades. Within one of New York City's most vibrant and eclectic boroughs, young women of color like Nadira, Gabby, Naz, Trish, Angelique, and countless others attempt to reconcile their immigrant backgrounds with the American culture in which they come of age. Here they become friends for life, or so they vow. Exuberant and wild, together they roam the city that never sleeps, sing Mariah Carey at the tops of their lungs, yearn for crushes who pay them no mind, and break the hearts of those who do, all while trying to heed their mother's commands to be obedient daughters. But as they age, their paths diverge and rifts form between them, as some choose to remain on familiar streets while others find themselves ascending in the world. A blazingly original debut novel told by a chorus of unforgettable voices, Brown Girls illustrates a collective portrait of childhood, adulthood, and beyond, and it is a striking exploration of female friendship. And those are my 3 and 3 picks. I hope you enjoy these books as much as I have.